Thank you. excelsis Deo.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Oh. Thank you.
represented by the altar, the lamb, and the cross. The whole of the apparition shows forth Our Lady's irreplaceable mission as Queen of Heaven, for she intercedes for us always before her glorious Son, seated at the right hand of the Father, dressed upon the brow of Our Lady, recalling her title of mystical rose, is a sign of the unique favor which God granted to the Virgin Mary from the moment of her conception, the favor granted to her for the salvation of us all. An abundant and warm light surrounded the entire apparition on that rainy eve of the octave of the Assumption, the Queenship of Mary in our current liturgical calendar. The beautiful light which bathed the sight of the apparition in the dampness of the rain and the darkness of the night was a sign of the lasting spiritual light which Our Lady of Knock was bringing into a desolate place, beset by many hardships, including the famine and evictions. The saintly Archdeacon Bartholomew Cavanaugh, parish priest of Knock, declared regarding the apparition, "Now she, the loving Queen of Heaven, has come down to us. She has come to us in our great grief and suffering to help us to be submissive to the will of God. And the blessings she has brought are availed to us by people from all parts." Our Blessed Mother, in her unceasing care for all men, comes to our help at Knock, to show those who come to her on pilgrimage the sure source of hope, her Son, our Lord Jesus, in the midst of all their trials and difficulties, and to lead them to Him. In the apparition to the left of St. John the Apostle is the altar of sacrifice, with the Lamb of God standing upon it and a large cross behind the Lamb. Although Our Lady is in the center of the apparition, the focus of the apparition is, in fact, the altar with the Lamb of God and the cross. It clearly identifies the reason why Our Lady, St. Joseph, and St. John the Apostle appear, namely, to worship the Lamb of God and to beckon all pilgrims to join them in worship of the Redeemer. Judge William D. Coyne, in his classic book on the apparition, treats the four main aspects of the vision, namely, the symbolism of the altar and the Lamb, Our Lady's place in the apparition, St. Joseph's spouse, foster father, and patron, St. John the disciple, whom Jesus loved, model of bishops and priests, representative of the whole human race on the hill of Calvary. He lists the altar and the Lamb and the cross as the first aspect. He immediately notes that volumes could be written about the meaning of the first aspect. At the same time, he rightly observes, no words were required to convey to Irish minds the meaning of an altar with a Lamb and a cross. A particular feature of the apparition of Our Lady of Knock, together with St. Joseph and St. John the Apostle, is the absolute silence of the heavenly figures, beginning with Our Lady. If we contemplate the image of the apparition, the message is clear. The message is Jesus Christ, God the Son incarnate, and His real presence with us in the most blessed sacrament. Through the sacrifice on Calvary, represented by the cross, Christ, the Lamb of God, who takes away the sin of the world, is our only hope of salvation. He makes ever present the sacrifice of Calvary on the altar whenever the Holy Mass is celebrated. Judge Coyne observes, it would appear that it is the Mass that matters at Knock too. And if we make the Holy Mass the focus round which devotions at the shrine center, we cannot have misinterpreted the lessons of the manifestations. For the holy sacrifice is the soul of our faith, and if not shrine helps us to increase devotion to the Mass, it will but continue for us, by the grace of God, the great national tradition passed down to us by our persecuted forefathers. Every aspect of the apparition of Our Lady of Knock directs us to the Holy Eucharist as the highest and most perfect expression of our life in Christ. Making reference to the teaching of St. Thomas Aquinas, the fathers at the Second Vatican Ecumenical Council declared simply, "For in the Most Holy Eucharist is contained the entire spiritual good of the Church." In his last encyclical letter, Ecclesia de Eucharistia, Blessed Pope John Paul II described Eucharistic faith in a striking manner. He reminded us that the life of the Church has its foundation and wellspring in the sacred triduum, which is fully contained in the Eucharistic mystery. As he wrote, "The Paschal Triduum is, as it were, gathered up, foreshadowed and concentrated forever in the gift of the Holy Eucharist." One understands immediately that Our Lady of Knock, wanting to show her children the unquenchable light of divine love, in the midst of the darkness of their many trials, appeared with the image of the altar, the Lamb, and the cross. Our Lady of Knock, as she has unfailingly done since August 21st, 1879, beckons pilgrims to her shrine so that she may show to them, as she has shown to pilgrims for some 132 years, her divine Son, who alone is our salvation. With maternal love, she has brought us here to an extraordinary place, a place made holy by the many graces and favors granted to pilgrims through her intercession before the throne of God. Manifests anew the extraordinary nature of our ordinary life lived in Christ, who abides within our souls through the outpouring of the Holy Spirit. The shrine of Our Lady of Knock, Queen of Heaven, continues to be bathed with the light which radiates from her immaculate heart, the divine light which our Lord Jesus never ceases to pour forth for us from his glorious, pierced heart. Our Lord has granted that his mother, like the divine wisdom praised in the book of Sirach, dwell in this place of pilgrimage, united to Jerusalem, the beloved city of our salvation, to minister before him by drawing pilgrims to know more deeply and love more ardently the mystery of his real presence with us in the Most Blessed Sacrament. In this holy shrine, following the example of the Mother of God and imploring her intercession, we discover anew that our true inheritance is the Lord, and that our lasting abode is in the full assembly of the saints. Coming on pilgrimage to the shrine of Our Lady of Knock, we understand more and more the meaning of our Lord's words in the Gospel. When a woman in the midst of the crowd, listening to his teaching, cried out in praise of his mother, of the womb that bore him, our Lord pointed to the true source of his mother's beatitude, namely, her perfect obedience to the law of God, through which she was prepared to be his mother. He declared, "Blessed rather are those who hear the word of God and keep it." For our pilgrimage, the Mother of God invites us to imitate her obedience, so that our Lord may purify our hearts of the wrong affections which lead us into sin and death, and may inflame our hearts with the love of his law, which leads us into virtue and everlasting life. Here's part of Jesus. St. Joseph, husband of Mary and foster father of Jesus, is patron of the Universal Church. He teaches us how to be with Mary, co-workers in Christ's saving mission. As a good father, he prays in a powerful way for the Universal Church and all her needs. We live in most troubled times throughout the world. The Church in Ireland, beloved to our Lady of Knock, is undergoing a particularly difficult time of suffering. But we must never give way to discouragement or abandon hope. For Our Lady draws us here to this sacred place, to our only source of hope, the real presence of our Lord Jesus Christ in the Most Blessed Sacrament. We cannot fight and win the fierce spiritual battles of our time by means of our own cleverness. Christ, our Eucharistic Lord, however, is with us. He alone can conquer sin in us, and on the last day he will restore us all and all of creation to God the Father in eternal glory. Here Our Lady teaches us, through the knowledge and love of the Holy Eucharist, to get our hearts one with her Immaculate Heart in devoted love of Christ. Here the Virgin Mary teaches us to offer with her devoted love to God the Father, who has first loved us and sent his Son to be the expiation for our sins, and in his Son has loved us to the end. In these troubled times, let us consider in particular the apparition of St. John the Apostle with Our Lady of Knock. St. John the Apostle represents the essential vocation of our Holy Father, the bishops in communion with him, and their co-workers, the priests, in the work of our salvation. As a true shepherd, he raises his right hand in the direction of the Virgin Mary, our Queen. With her, in the silence of the apparition, he leads us to the Lamb of God, to the altar of his sacrifice, and to the cross. Coming on pilgrimage to Our Lady of Knock, we are filled with love for our Holy Father, Pope Benedict XVI, our bishops and priests, and we are inspired to pray for them, so that they remain faithful and generous and pure, and responding daily to their high calling on behalf of us all. In his last encyclical letter, Blessed Pope John Paul II strikingly described the wonder which should fill the mind and heart of every priest when he is offering the Holy Mass. Christ's action through the priest ministry truly unites heaven and earth, for it makes present the glorious body, blood, soul, and divinity of Christ for the salvation of the world. Blessed Pope John Paul II wrote these words about the profound amazement and gratitude before the reality of the Eucharistic sacrifice, which should fill the minds and hearts of all the faithful, and especially of priests. He wrote that the amazement should always fill the church assembled for the celebration of the Eucharist, but in a special way it should fill the minister of the Eucharist, for it is he who, by the authority given him in the sacrament of priestly ordination, effects the consecration. It is he who says, with the power coming to him from Christ in the upper room, "This is my body which will be given up for you. This is the cup of my blood poured out for you." The priest says these words, or rather he puts his voice at the disposal of the one who spoke these words in the upper room, and who desires that they should be repeated in every generation by all those in the church who in the church ministerially share in his priesthood. The apparition of Our Lady of Knock is a most eloquent expression of awe and gratitude before the Most Blessed Sacrament. Here Our Lady, together with St. Joseph and St. John the Apostle, reminds us that in the Eucharistic sacrifice, we witness directly the mystery of the immense love of our Lord Jesus Christ for all men without boundary. It is the mystery which our Lord expressed with his words as he was dying upon the cross for the salvation of the world. I thirst. The ordained priest is called to share in the thirst of Christ for souls, which is immeasurable and without cease. Let us pray through the intercession of Our Lady of Knock that by their devotion to the Most Blessed Sacrament, our priests will come to an ever deeper appreciation of their call to pastoral charity. How much the attitudes, words, and actions of the priest, who is devoted in his love of the Most Blessed Sacrament, will, with St. John the Apostle, give witness to the truth of the mystery of faith, the Holy Eucharist, which at its every celebration embraces the whole world with love. Let us pray that through Eucharistic faith and devotion, priests and all the faithful will be always deeply conscious that the priesthood is a gift given by Christ to his church, so that he might be present in every time and place as head and shepherd of the flock, giving his life for the flock above all through the offering of the holy sacrifice of Mass. At Knock, the Blessed Virgin Mary, together with St. Joseph and St. John the Apostle, shows us anew the great gift of our life in her divine Son. Here we pray with Mary and with St. Joseph and St. John the Apostle, and through their intercession, we receive the grace to follow Christ faithfully on the way of the cross throughout the days of our earthly pilgrimage, and to reach with Christ the goal of our pilgrimage, eternal life in the kingdom of heaven. As pilgrims to the sanctuary of Our Lady at Knock, let us pray through the intercession of the Mother of God for the grace to center our lives upon the Most Blessed Sacrament as the font of the divine wisdom and strength which we need to follow Christ faithfully throughout the days of our earthly pilgrimage. Placing our hearts, one with the Immaculate Heart of Mary, into the Sacred Heart of Jesus, who are worship of God the Father, we return pure and selfless love to God, who has first loved us. We recognize that our true inheritance is the Lord, and we remain steadfast along the way which leads to our lasting home in the full assembly of the saints. As we have come to venerate Our Lady of Knock, so let us now be one with the Immaculate Heart of Mary, united in the glorious pierced heart of Jesus. As we have been one with him in his Eucharistic sacrifice, offering our lives in pure and selfless love, let us pray that through our pilgrimage, Our Lady will help us, as she has helped her faithful children from the time of her appearance on August 21st, 1879, to give our hearts totally to Christ every day of our lives, and to reach with Christ our lasting home in heaven. Heart of Jesus, fountain of life and holiness, have mercy on us. Our Lady of Knock, Queen of Heaven and Queen of Ireland, St. Joseph, patron of the universal church, St. John the Apostle, pray for us. St. Patrick, Apostle of Ireland, pray for us. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen.